So what's up people, it's your boy Yot and welcome to Steady Bro. Regulation, it seems they haven't forgotten about us. A few days ago, on the 21st of October, the GMC released the interim standards of practice. Interim suggests, of course, they are not the conclusive ones and they could be subject to changes. However, this is what we have so far. These standards take a great deal of inspiration from the good medical practice set out for doctors. Given the similarities between the two professions, this comes as no surprise. However, because the professions are different, these standards have been tailored where appropriate to better fit the needs of a physician associate. This is a 28-page document with forming chapters. Knowledge, skills, and performance, chapter 1. Safety and equality, chapter 2. Community, partnership, and teamwork, chapter 3. And maintaining trust, chapter 4. I'm not going to bore you with every single commandment. There are 80 of them. If I were you watching this video and I began going chapter 1, commandment 1, thou shalt not, I would just click off the video. So what I'll do is I'll put a link down in the description where you can see the whole document and examine it to your heart's content. I'll just pick a couple, one or two I found interesting and just talk about it. Knowledge, skills and performance. KSPO for short. This sounds like a bout of coronavirus. So chapter 1, commandment 14. You must recognize and work within the limits of your competence. This is one commandment I suspect most are waiting for a clarification on. I do believe it is the main reason for the regulation. What can they do and what can they not do? Where does their scope end? I think this is one thing most are really waiting for. At present, some feel the lines are blurred. Of course, the PA metrics does exist to help deal with this problem. But as you can clearly tell for yourself, it's a gradient. There is no defined limit. If your supervisor is happy for you to carry out a certain task, once they've ascertained your competence in it, it's fair game. Some are hoping that if the profession is regulated under the GMC, there'll be a clear line. After QXYZ, physician associates should not touch. And we'll see the regulation does bring forth said clear defined lines. These limits of competence are important once defined, as I believe it will settle the cries of mid-level creep, scope creep that some of our siblings from another mother are worried about. It should equip them with the ammunition. I mean, the common grounds that we can both agree on to call a spade. So there'll be a clear line beyond which we can all agree one is creeping, below which we can all agree.
Why you always lying? Oh my God, stop.
Bro, if a lawyer is watching this video, they'll be so disappointed. You know how they go to the court and then shout, Your Honor, objection, my lord. Article 15, subparagraph B, comma, Q, stroke E. That would be so sick. I'm trying to make this look like, you know, a court proceeding. Chapter 1, commandment 16, subparagraph E. In providing clinical care, you must respect the patient's desire to seek second opinion. Hold on. If you go to commandment 5, it says must, as used in this document, is an overriding principle or duty. And this is how I interpreted it. Assuming you have a patient who you think has a viral cough, upon examination, taking the history and everything, you center the hell out of their symptoms and you've concluded that no antibiotics is necessary. This patient still has the right to tell you, I want a second opinion. I want the doctor's opinion. You have to give it to them. And they are not being rude. Though I must admit, some of them can be rude. I remember this one particular incident. A parent and child came to my clinic. Parent wanted a referral for the child for X, Y, and Z. However, previously, a letter from pediatrics had made clear that for you to refer patient X to us for X, Y, and Z, A plus B must be below zero, which I clearly pointed out to the parents. But clearly, as we can all see, A plus B is above one. There is no need for me to do this referral. During the consultation, I told them I was not a doctor, I was a physician associate. When the parent recognized that I was not going to concede, bro, I got hit with a shoryuken. Bow! You are not a doctor. Hadouken. Why am I even speaking to you? The desire to speak with a doctor, it's not problematic. It was what it was about. The timing. Oh, that was impeccable timing. Yo, I felt all types of weight. I said, fine. I went to doc. Doc agreed with me. Doc came, spoke to the patient, said, look, PH right. 1 plus 1 equals 2, A plus B is above 0, so referral not necessary. Doc didn't say a single word different from what I had already told the patient. The patient accepted. Then the patient left the room. But then I sat in there, I was like, damn. It's like the mere fact I was not a doctor meant me telling the patient that H2O is water and that 1 plus 1 equals 2, like, was not good enough. So yes, it's their right. But I do believe some folks will use this as the infinity gauntlet. You say something they don't like, they don't agree with you, I want to see a doctor. So next time when a patient wants to see a doctor, I will just shout, Doc! There are 78 other commandments. I'm not going to bore you. This was just a quick update on the physician associate regulation. We are still waiting to see if they do present a document clearly delineating the scope of practice and to see how things progress. So they have not forgotten about us. COVID has definitely delayed stuff, but the GMC is still working and trying to get this profession regulated. It's your boy Yoti, and I'm out. Salute!